Hello, everyone, and welcome back to our series on creating and uploading an Amazon Workspaces Bring Your Own License or BYOL image. So far, Dave and I have shown you how to create an image using Hyper-V and VMware Workstation. And now, in part one of this wrap-up series, we are going to see how we can install the Amazon command line interface. We're then going to take a look at how we configure the command line interface to make API calls into our AWS account. And then we're going to create an Amazon Simple Storage Service or Amazon S3 bucket. Let's jump right in.
So the first place we're going to start is by downloading the Amazon Command Line Interface or CLI. So I have already navigated to that website, and over here on the right-hand side of the page, you can see we have the installs for the different operating systems that we support. In my case, I am going to choose Windows. I'm going to go ahead and run this install. And for this install, I will be selecting all the defaults. And once we kick this off, it will take just a moment to install. So I will pause the video and come back after the install. Great. So we have that installed. So now I'm going to open up a command prompt and run an AWS space question mark. And we can see now that we have different commands for the AWS CLI.
Now that we have the AWS CLI installed, we are going to configure the AWS CLI to be able to communicate with our AWS account. To do this, we are going to run AWS configure. I am going to throw in an extra command here. You could typically just run this, and this would set up the default profile. But I am going to run dash dash profile, give this a name, hit enter, and here is where we're going to enter our AWS access keys. Now for default region, I am going to use US East 1, and for default output format, I'm going to use JSON. Now there are other ways to configure the command line interface to interact with your AWS account. From a security perspective, for this demo, I chose the way that was easiest for me. For you, make sure you follow your organization's best practice by either using access keys or potentially even using the AWS Identity and Access Management Center to be able to authenticate into your AWS account with the CLI. Now, as a reminder, there is no need to try to quickly jot down the URLs that I'm using for this. I will link all those in the description below. The next thing we need to do is to create an Amazon Simple Storage Service or Amazon S3 bucket. To do so, we're going to log into the AWS account. I am already logged into mine. We are going to navigate over to S3. If it is not in your recently visited items, like it is for me, you can simply go up to the search, type in S3, and it should be the first option. After we get into the S3 console, over to the right-hand side, we have Create Bucket. We are going to select that. Once we are in the Create Bucket console, we're going to type a name for our bucket. Typically, as I name my buckets, I will add my initials with a date, because as a reminder, to create an S3 bucket, it does have to be a globally unique name. So I find at least adding in today's date behind most of your names will get you over that hurdle. Now here, I am going to keep all the defaults. I am going to double check that block all public access is on, and then I am going to scroll down and click Create Bucket. Now, as always in creating S3 buckets, please follow your organization's best practices for securing and limiting access to that bucket. For our demo, this will work just fine. And there you have it for part one. In this video, we installed and configured Amazon's command line interface to be able to make API calls into our AWS account. We then created an Amazon S3 bucket that we are going to use in part two of this wrap-up series. As mentioned during the video, there were some key links that I used throughout the video. I have put them up on the screen here, but I will also link them in the video description below. Thank you all for watching, and be on the lookout for part two of a wrap-up series where we're going to copy that image that we have in our local machine to that S3 bucket we created take a look at some permissions required to import that image into Amazon Workspaces, and then we're going to create an Amazon Workspaces and an Amazon Workspaces Core BYOL image. I look forward to seeing you all in that next video.